गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, साई राम। लास्ट क्लास वी सॉ राउंडिंग ऑफ द नंबर्स टू द नियरेस्ट टेन्स, हंड्रेड्स एंड थाउजेंड। यस, सो जस्ट वील हैव अ रिवाइज ऑफ दैट एंड वील सी वन न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट टुडे। यस, सो राउंडिंग ऑफ टू द नियरेस्ट टेन, व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू सी द डिजिट एट द वंस प्लेस। यस, इफ द डिजिट एट द वंस प्लेस is 4 or less than 4, what you have to do? Place zeros in the ones place and the tens place remains the same. If the digit at the ones place is 5 or more than 5, what you have to do? Place zero in the ones place and also add 1 to the digit at the thousands place. Next, rounding off to the nearest hundred. You have to see the which digit? You have to see the digit at the tens place. Yes? So, if the digit at the tens place is 4 or less than 4, what you have to do? Place zeros in the ones and the tens place and the hundreds place remains the same. Next, if the digit at the tens place is 5 or more than 5, then place zeros in the ones and the tens place and also add 1 to the digit at the thousands place. Now, rounding off to the nearest thousand. So, you have to see the digit at the hundreds place. The digit at the hundreds place is 4 or less than 4. What you have to do? Place zeros in the ones, tens and hundreds place and thousands place remains the same. And if the digit at the thousands place is 5 or more than 5, what you have to do? Place zeros in the ones, tens and hundreds place or also add 1 to the digit at the thousands place. Next, today we'll see even on odd numbers, shall we? So the object that are in twos form a pair. We'll see what is a pair. The object that are in twos form a pair. Let me repeat. The object that are in twos form a pair. Now count the circles now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many circles? 6. Now, can we make it as a pair? So, 2 makes a pair, right? So, 2, 2, 2. How many pairs? 3 pairs. So, you know what is a pair? The object that are in twos form a pair. Next, we'll see what is an even number. Numbers which can be put into pairs are called even numbers. Let me repeat. Numbers which can be put into pairs or called even numbers. So, if you can put the objects into pairs, that is called what number? It is an even number. Yes. So, 10, 10, 0, 10, can you make it as a pair? Yes, 5 pairs we can make, right? So, 0, we cannot make any pair. 2. 0, 10, we can make it as a pair, right? So, 0 I'm putting. 2, we can make 1 pair, right? So, 4, how many pairs? 2 pairs, we can make 2 pairs. And 6, 3 pairs, we can make 3 pairs, right? And next, 8, how many pairs? 4 pairs, we can make 4 pairs. So, numbers which can be put into pairs are called even numbers. So, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. We can make them into pairs, right? Numbers ending in 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 or even numbers. Let me repeat. Numbers ending in 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 or even numbers. So, if the number ends with 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 or what numbers? It is an even number, right? So we'll see some examples now. 238. It is an even number as it ends with 8. So for bigger number, you cannot make so much of pairs, right? Can you make so much of pairs? No, it's very difficult. So you have to see the ending number. 1746. 1746. It ends with 6. It's an even number. Next, 3280. 3280. It ends with 0. So it's an even number. 7632. It ends with 2. So it's also an even number. Numbers ending in 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 are even numbers. Now we'll move on to odd numbers. We'll see what is an odd number. Numbers which cannot be put in pairs or called odd numbers. Numbers which cannot be put in pairs or called odd numbers. So if you cannot make them into pairs, that is called odd number, right? So 1, can you make it as a pair? No. 3, for first two numbers we can make a pair. Third will be, there is no pair, right? So for 5 also, can you make it as a pair? No. For 7, no. Then for 9, no, you cannot make pair for these numbers. So 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, you cannot make pairs, right? We'll see now. Numbers ending in 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 are odd numbers. Tell me. Numbers ending in 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 are odd numbers. See, for bigger number, we cannot make pairs, right? So we'll see the ending number. If it ends with 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9, then it is an odd number. We'll see some examples now. 413. 413 is an odd number as it ends with 3. 685. Odd or even? It's an odd number as it ends with 5. Next, 7981. Again, it's an odd number, right? As it ends with 1. 7981 is an odd number. Then 9377. It's an odd number as it ends with 7. So we'll see one example now. Separate and write the even and odd numbers into their respective boxes. Separate and write the even and odd numbers in their respective boxes. So many numbers are displayed here, right? I have given so many numbers. Now you are going to say which one is odd, which is uneven. Yes? So I'll say the numbers now. 46, 46, 83, 220, �● 4783. Now you are going to tell me which is an odd or which is an even number. Now tell me, 46 is an odd or even number? It's an even number. Very good. As it ends with 6. I'm going to write, see, even, odd. I'm going to write down of even number. 46 is an even number. Yes, we are going to write in these boxes whether it is, if it is even, I'm going to write the down of even number. If it is odd, I'm going to write it down of odd number. Shall we? So 83, odd or even? It's an odd number, right? As it ends with 3. So 83, I'm writing it down of odd. 83 is an odd number as it ends with 3. 175, you're going to tell me now whether it is an odd or even number. It's an odd number. 175 is an odd number as it ends with 5. So I'm writing it down of odd. 175 is an odd number. Next, 220. 220. Now tell me whether it is an odd or even number. It's an even number as it ends with 0. As it ends with 0, it's an even number. So I'm writing it down of even 220. Then 1643. 1643. Whether it is an odd or even. Think and tell me now. Yes, it's an odd number. Very good. So I'm writing it down of odd. 1643 is an odd number as it ends with 3. Next, 2040. Odd or even number? It's an even number as it ends with 0. So I'm writing it down of even number. 2040 is an even number. Then 9891. Whether it is an odd or even? Yes, it is an odd number as it ends with 1. 9891 is an odd number. Then 687. Whether it is an odd number or even number? It's an odd number, right? So as it ends with 7, 687 is an odd number. Then 1849. Odd or even number? Again, it is an odd number as it ends with 9. Shall we write down of odd number? Yes, 1849 is an odd number. Then 7514. Whether it is an odd or even number? It's an even number as it ends with 4, right? So 7514 is an even number. Then 6322. Odd or even number? It's an even number as it ends with 2. So 6322 is an even number. I'm writing it down of even number. Then 9295. Odd or even number? It's an odd number, right? As it ends with 5. It's an odd number. 5040. It's an even number. Very good. So 5040 is an even number as it ends with 0. Then last, 4783. It's an odd number as it ends with 3. So now you all know what is an even and odd number, right? The numbers that is ending with 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 or even numbers. And numbers ending with 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 are odd numbers. So, till this our first class chapter is over. So, now we are going to revise the previous classes. Shall we? Draw beads to represent the number into the boxes. So, you all know to represent the number in an abacus, isn't it? Shall we see some examples now? So, first number is 3521. Second number is 2106. Now we are going to represent this number on the abacus, shall we? Now, in ones place we have the number 1. So I'm placing 1 bead. So first number 3521, we have 1 in the ones place. So how many beads I have to place? 1 bead. So I'm placing 1 bead. I'll place 1 bead. Next, tens place, how many number? 2. So I'm placing how many beads? 2 beads. So 1, 2. Then hundreds place, we have the number 5. So you have to place 5 beads. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Very good. Then thousands place, what number we have? 3. So how many beads you have to place? 3 beads, isn't it? 1, 2, 3. Very good. Next, 2106. So in ones place, how many beads we have? See how many, what number we have? 6. So we have to place 6 beads in the ones place. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 beads. Then in tens place, what number we have? 0. So no need to place any bead. Then hundreds place, what number we have? 1. So I'm placing only one bead. Place one bead. Then thousands place, we have the number 2, right? So we have to place 2 beads. 1, 2. So you all know how to represent number in an abacus. Yes? Next one, fill in the boxes. Now I've given one number. You are going to tell me how many thousands, how many hundreds, how many tens and how many ones. And you're going to form a number also. Shall we see? 7, 9, 8, 2. 2 in the ones place, 8 in the tens place, 9 in the hundreds place, 7 in the thousands place. Now tell me how many thousands are there? 7. So I'm writing 7 in the first box. 7,000. Then how many hundreds? 900. Very good. Then how many tens? 8. Very good. 8 tens. And how many ones? 2 ones. 7,000. 900, 8 tens and 2 ones. Second one, see they have given the 6000 plus 0 hundred and 1 tens and 9 ones. You're going to form the number. Yes? So in thousands place what we have? 6. In hundreds place 0. Tens place 1 and ones place 9. So the number is 6, 0, 1, 9. 6, 0, 1, 9. Third one, 4, 7, 8, 0. 4, 7, 8, 0. Now tell me how many thousands? Yes, very good. 4,000. Very good. Then, so I'm writing 4 in the first box. Second one, how many hundreds? 700. Very good. 700 plus how many tens? 8 tens. Very good. Then how many ones? 0 ones. So 4,700 plus 8 tens and 0 ones. Now expanded form. Write in the expanded form. Now tell me children, what do you mean by expanded form? Yes, it is the sum of the, sum means addition, plus it is the sum of the place value of the digit. Place value of the digit, isn't it? So first one, 4,208. You're going to write in the expanded form. Now tell me 4 it is in which place? 8 in the ones place, 0 in the tens place, 2 in the hundreds place and 4 in the thousand place. So 4 into 1000, 4000. Very good. So I'm writing 4000. I've written 4000 plus. Then 2 in the hundreds place. So 2 into 100, 200 plus 0 plus 8. So 4000 plus 200 plus 0 plus 8. Second one, 1635. Now write in the expanded form. You're going to tell me the answer now. So 5 in the ones place, 3 in the tens place, 6 in the hundreds place and 1 in the thousands place. So how many thousand? 1000. So I'm writing, I've written 1000 plus 6 in the hundreds place. 6 into 100, 600 plus 3 into 10, 330 plus 5. 1000 plus 600 plus 30 plus 5. Now we'll see. Write the how to write the number names. You all know to write the number names, isn't it? We'll see two examples now. 5, what is TH? 5000 plus 300 plus 7 tens plus 1 ones. Shall we see how to write the number names? We have to start from the leftmost part. How many thousands we have? 5,000. So I'm writing, I've written 5,371. 5,371. Very good. Second one, 8,000 plus 600 plus 5 tens plus 9 ones. Shall we write the number name for this? Yes. So how many thousands? 8,000. So 8,659. So you all know to write the number names, right? You have to start from the leftmost part. So given one worksheet, choose the correct answer, then fill in the boxes, same how many thousands, how many hundreds, how many tens and how many ones you're going to find out and write the boxes. Then write the expanded form. You all know to write the expanded form of a number, isn't it? So finish the worksheet. Practice well, children. See you in the next class. Thank you.